The preset controls of an effect device can be used to automatically adjust its parameters to some preset values, as well as allowing you to compare, save, import, and export those presets. Right-clicking on the A or B button will store the current set of parameter values. After they've been changed to something else, left-clicking will restore them back to those values. Storing to both A and B allows you to quickly switch between two different presets and compare them. Any presets stored like this are saved with your song, so you don't need to worry about losing them. The arrow buttons will change the device's parameters by moving through the list of available presets. Clicking on a preset name will show this list, along with some options. So, let's recreate the old Wanderer preset for the upgraded flanger device, and save it for later use. By choosing Save As from the menu and entering a name, the current parameters will be saved as a new preset. Saved presets are stored on your machine in the user library, which is found in one of these locations depending on your OS. The presets will show up every time you use the device in future across both Renoise and Redux, because they're compatible and share their data from this same user library. To save or load effect presets to or from disk using any location, perhaps to more easily share them with other users, you should instead use the import and export options. Finally, when they've been selected, user-created presets can also be renamed and deleted. Everything shown in this video works for all native effects: audio, meta, routing, and doofers. And this is mostly the same for non-native effects, with the addition of importing and exporting entire banks of presets. But not all of these third-party effects provide options for saving or renaming presets. And for those that do, this is handled through their own custom interface.